Welcome to another training video about Yamaha DM7 series of digital mixing consoles. This time I'm going to show you how to activate a license for the theatre or broadcast packages. Both are optional additions to the DM7 series, bringing specific features to those applications. Though of course, some will also be useful outside of those core areas. As a brief summary, the broadcast package includes mix minus, loudness metering and meter scale, audio follow video, fader cue release and backstop PFL, and source selection mix mode. While the theatre package includes the actor library with four banks of EQ and dynamics, DCA presets, DCA scene grid, and scenes that can transmit MIDI messages. Licenses for both packages are supplied with the DM7 control panel, or they can be purchased separately. Both can be authorized on the same console, if you wish. Once the physical package is opened, you will find a license code printed on a sheet of paper. Keep it safe. Now, the license activation process will vary depending on your geographic region, so it's best to check it with your local Yamaha supplier. In Europe, Japan, and an increasing range of other countries, you can use Yamaha's Provisionaire Portal app, allowing the license to be applied to the chosen console, either permanently or temporarily. I shall show you this method. Temporary activation means the license can later be transferred to a different console, useful for rental companies and other system providers. In other regions of the world, a different method will be required, allowing only permanent authorization to one console. See the Device License Activation Guide to review the available activation methods in each region. Before proceeding with license authorization, make sure you have all the devices and connections required. Of course, you need the console and the activation code. You also need the Provisionaire Portal app running on a smart device with a camera and internet connection. An iPhone, iPad, or Android device will work. The console doesn't need to be connected to the internet, though it does need to be on the same network as the smart device. If possible, connect the console to a network that has both Wi-Fi and a router with internet connection, so the smart device doesn't need to switch between two networks. You'll also need a web browser running, preferably on a Windows or Mac OS computer, though it could also work on a smart device. This is to create a user ID called Yamaha Music ID for Business, for log in to Yamaha Provisionaire Cloud and to register the license. You'll also need access to your email account for authentication. So let's begin at the web address provisionaire.yamaha.com. Click Sign In, then select New User. This is to create a Yamaha Music ID for Business account. Choose your country or region of residence and your language. Then you'll need to enter your email address, make a password, type your name, and select your date of birth. And of course, please read the terms of use and the privacy policy. This account should be unique to you and not shared with other colleagues, friends, or family. The next step is to either create or be invited to join an existing organization. This can be shared amongst multiple accounts in case a group of people need to administer a range of licenses. You are only required to type the organization name and select the country or region. The other data is optional. From one account, it's possible to manage multiple organizations, each shared with a different group of people. Now that's done, you can sign in to Provisionaire Cloud to register your license. At provisionaire.yamaha.com, sign in with your new Yamaha Music ID for Business account, entering the email address and password. Click Sign In and you'll be sent an email with a verification code. This will need to be entered before proceeding. After that, select the organization you want to use for managing the new license. This will either be the organization you just entered the details for, or another one that you have been invited to join. Click the Add License Code button and enter the license code that is shown on your broadcast or theater package license code leaflet. It will be 5 sets of 5 characters. You can then choose an alias name to give the license to make it easy to identify for all the colleagues registered with the organization. You'll then see that the status of the license is available. Now we need to use the Provisionaire portal on the mobile smart device to communicate with the mixer and activate the licenses. This is where we need a Wi-Fi connection to the console at the same time as internet access for the Provisionaire Cloud server. So make sure these are ready. If all the devices can reside on the same subnet with a router to the internet, it will be easiest, avoiding the need for the smart device to switch between 2 different Wi-Fi networks or between Wi-Fi and 4G or 5G. Sign in with your Yamaha Music ID for Business and touch the camera icon in order to scan the QR code on the product. On DM7, from the utility screen's home menu, touch System and License Activation. Then touch QR code near the bottom of the screen. Scan this from the smart device, and Provisionaire Portal will aim to verify the serial number and model of the device by communicating with it via the network. Provisionaire Portal will then check the online server to find any available license you have registered. You can choose whether to activate the license permanently or temporarily. If you choose temporarily, you'll be able to deactivate the license in future and reactivate it to another device. This offers greater flexibility for mixing consoles that get used for a wide variety of different temporary events. As the activation proceeds, Provisionaire Portal will act as the communication gateway between the server and the mixing console. If your console doesn't have an internet connection, be aware that you may need to switch your smart device between Wi-Fi and 4G or 5G connections to complete the process. After it's complete, Provisionaire Portal will display the license as installed and the console will ask to be rebooted for activating the additional functions. If it's a temporary activation, it will be available to deactivate another time. Remember, you are free to activate both the broadcast package and the theatre package licenses onto a single console to obtain maximum functionality. Don't miss my other videos explaining how these new features can be used to enhance the workflow of most theatre and broadcast customers, and many others from different applications. Enjoy all that the amazing DM7 series has to offer. Unparalleled sound quality, ease of operation, and high reliability. I'll see you again here soon.